There's so many different things.
Good morning. We're about to begin the 92nd Annual Remembrance Day commemoration here at Victory Square. Now, in a few moments, the Bach Youth Choir and Sanner Band will set the mood with songs for this special day. I wish to take a moment to acknowledge and thank the numerous volunteers assisting with today's ceremony and the scouts and pathfinders who are distributing programs and poppies. In about 15 minutes, marching units of veterans, regimental groups, serving members of the armed forces, brass and pipe bands, police services and cadets will begin marching north on Canby and form up in front of the cenotaph. Today's ceremony will broadcast live on Global TV and CTV beginning at 10:30. Now, let us enjoy the wonderful voices of the Bach Youth Choir and Sarah.
Is the Vancouver Tri-Party consisting of cadets from Army
Navy, Air, and St. John Indians. The Vigil Guard represents the Navy, Army, Air Force, and RCMP, and are selected for their excellence in drill, dress, and deportment. The Vigil Guard commander today is Sergeant Stephen Kaw of the British Columbia Regiment, DCO. The first guard includes Leading Seaman Brian Stephan of HMCS Discovery. He joined the Naval Reserve in 2006 and is currently attached to the Operations Department at Discovery. Thank you. this day without interruption for 92 years. If you're able, we stand. Captain Andrew Greenwood, Vancouver Bob-U Fire and Saragat, accompanied by the Vancouver Fire and Rescue Services Band, will now lead in the singing of Old Canada. The words are in your program, so please join in the singing of our national anthem.
Including sailors,
soldiers, airmen, airwomen, nursing sisters, and merchant marines. There are about 72,000 Canadian veterans of that war still with us today, most in their 90s. Some are with us today. Some are at home watching us. Along with those attending November 11th ceremonies across British Columbia and Canada. These men and women who survived, endured, and helped to renew our great country are part of our legacy of remembrance. Most recently, the war in Afghanistan took its toll, including those who could not deal with the effects of that conflict. Now, these veterans and their families need our attention, and all of us must encourage our governments to do so on our behalf. Trumpeters Joe Foster and Dan McLeod will now sound the last post.
board. Behind us.
Assisted by an air cadet.